A boy leaves the bathroom to return to his classroom when he sees the attacker and narrowly escapes. Then the shooter enters adjoining classrooms. 111 and 112.
I look at the wall, and the wall's there. Pieces falling off the wall. And that's when I realize it's the madness. Is it
good? In just 3 minutes, the government fires more than 100 rounds. Chief Alejandro later recounts entering the school to investigators.
As we approach the doors, we get fire coming out, and those come out through the walls in some other direction.
All the cameras show officers approach rooms 111 and 112. The attacker behind a closed door fires at the officers. Two of them sustain grazing wounds. They retreat. The initial chance to confront the shooter in that classroom, gone. The other officers also come under fire. Seconds later, the acting Uvalde City Police Chief that day, Lieutenant Mariano Vargas, is also at the school, seen here in that hallway. At this point, no officer fires at the gunman. And after officers are inside the school, the gunman fires approximately 16 additional rounds over the next 5 minutes. Chief Alejandro later said he dropped his radios before entering the building because he thought they would slow him down. He calls a police landline from his cell phone. While investigators point to many failures this day, they tell ABC News that these moments, soon after school police Chief Alejandro arrives, are especially crucial.
Initially, it was reported that this was a barricaded subject, but this was a hostage situation. This was not a barricaded subject, it was in fact an active shooter.
Chief Alejandro later said he thought the attacker was cornered. Investigators say he failed to recognize the attack as an active shooter in those pivotal moments.
Clearly, the failure right at the beginning was the inability of the officers all seen to continue to engage the subject field he was neutralized first. If you don't immediately confront an active shooter, it'll have to be lost.
It's a place where you have to step up. Put your own life on the line, that starts at the top.
And according to a school district active shooter plan, written in part by Chief Alejandro himself, he was the officer at the top, the one who was to assume leadership and command in the event of an active shooter.
This event took place in school. Now under the jurisdiction authority of the school police, the chief of the school police was on scene.
There's no question about it, but he was the on-scene commander in the hallway.
Chief Alejandro would later tell investigators he did not see himself as the commander that day. The time is about 11:45 a.m., and there are 18 officers in the building, according to records reviewed by ABC News. 12 minutes as the attacker entered the school. Officers are now responding to the school from all law enforcement agencies, including Border Patrol and the Texas Department of Public Safety.
Someone showing up the scene is very difficult to try to process because this is still an active shooter. I mean, people waiting around, because you don't wait around in an active shooter situation.
Wait, Jim is in a different building. Hold on.
Anxious parents are gathering outside the school, desperate for information. Gloria and Javier Cáceres, seen here in the red shirt, are right there, searching for their daughter, Jackie.
Police, we're trying to get back. Are they better for those in love? Confused around the results.
Inside, Chief Alejandro makes the decision to evacuate children from neighboring classrooms.
There's probably some seats in there we really need more from out here, so I call that and I say, get these kids out.
But the rescuing those children in neighboring classrooms before stopping the gunman goes against active shooter training, according to law enforcement officials.
Learn that lesson. Don't recall about it. Nothing sensitive in an active shooter situation is to immediately locate the subject, isolate, and neutralize.
But instead of confronting the shooter, Chief Alejandro tries to negotiate with the attacker. As other officers continue evacuating children from other classrooms.
At this point, they're coming out. None of us even are coming.
The time is now 12 p.m., 27 minutes after the attacker entered the school. There are 28 officers in the building. And while children are evacuated from other classrooms, one 10-year-old girl calls 911 from inside a classroom under attack. For a series of phone calls, 10-year-old Chloe Flores pleads for help. Chloe, whose family knows to block active portions of a 911 call and
walk-in. Makers in those hallways.
And there was no command post set up to centralize information. No one collecting and effectively.